So when I realized about 7-8 years back that all of us have been moved, made to flee for their lives, and have to now raise children outside Kashmir without the facility for language, without the facility for the same lifestyle, rituals, culture, food, clothes, neighborhood, whatever gives you an identity. You see, if you lose your language, for example, it is one of the most important markers of your identity. What are you left with? If you lose your food habit, if you lose your clothing, if you lose your community celebrations, festivals, you get assimilated in the neighborhoods where you're scattered around India and across the world. You become a namesake Kashmiri. Perhaps your nose, your skin color, over a period of time, that also will give way, but that's what remains. So I thought, let me start documenting it, and we started publishing in Roots in Kashmir, a journal called Prajnat. We called it of Kashmiri culture and identity, a documentation. We thought we need to preserve it. If someday, somewhere, somebody feels the pangs to know who we are, how we were, what we did, where have we come from, how did we reach here, there should be a ready reckoner. So in that, I once wrote about Sharada Peeth, and I spoke to someone who I knew had gone to Sharada Peeth. His name was Professor Nazki. Professor Farooq Nazki. His some friends or relatives lived in Muzaffarabad, Kashmir. He had gone there to attend a wedding, and he said, I decided to go to Sharada. And in the introduction of his travelogue, he says, I am the 14th generation descendant of Ganesh Dutt Kaul, who lived near the hillock of Hari Parvat and was the custodian of Sharika Mandir. I am his 14th generation descendant. I don't know what has come upon me. I don't know what is pulling me. It is taking me to Sharada. And he walks. And he reaches there. And he talks about its magnificence, and he talks about how these 14 generations have lived since. He clicks pictures, and I publish that travelogue. And I'll for my life be indebted to him, because we can't go there. I can't go there. I'll never get the visa. But he went, and through his eyes, ears, and experiences, but there are very few such people who are willing to acknowledge their ancestry, and not just acknowledge, admit to it, celebrate it, go into print and suffer for it. His family has to live in Jammu, he cannot live in Kashmir anymore. He teaches in an agricultural college. That is what you've done to this Kashmir. There is another person, Meem Zafar Hai. Meem Zafar Hai chose to learn Sanskrit, chose to learn about Abhinav Gupta. He was so moved. When I met him, I said, what made you learn this? He said, do you think Abhinav Gupta is only yours? Abhinav Gupta is mine too. I thought it was a little rhetorical. But then I came to know he had named his son Abhinava. I only hope that this realization only grows, because knowledge, the Prophet himself said, is not of one persuasion, one ritual, one faith, one religion, one geography. Knowledge is universal. The word Hindu doesn't come even once in Bhagavad Gita or in Mahabharata. Or in Vedas, incidentally. Not once. But unfortunately, we are faced with an extremely narrow, blinkered, and aggressive espousal of an identity which even the word sectarian actually dignifies. Because what is happening in the world across, I mean, there is no Bajrang Dal in Syria, where ISIS is slaughtering Shias. There is no Vishwa Hindu Parishad in Pakistan, where Ahmadiyyas have been declared non-Muslims, and the first Muslim Nobel scientist, his grave tombstone was erased. The word Muslim was erased from his tombstone. That, never mind that it created a stupid, a very hilarious kind of sentence when they erased the word. The introduction was the first Muslim Nobel laureate for science. They erased the Muslim and it said the first Nobel laureate for science, which is obviously wrong. So that's the mindset. And the mindset is that the hill Shankaracharya in the middle of Srinagar city is now named Takht-e-Suleiman. The hill that has Sharika temple, to which Dr. Farooq Nazki claimed that his ancestor 14 generations ago was the caretaker, has been named Koh-e-Mahran. The temple where I mentioned about the Panchang, the Saptarishi Samvat, where all the Jyotishis of our community used to gather on the Varsh Pratipada, which is the first day of the year, to compare their Panchangs with each other. That place was called Vicharnag because they would exchange ideas and fine-tune their time calculations in order to arrive at an almanac which was with consensus. That Vicharnag is named Firdaus. The place which was Gaukadal connected Ganpatyar with another locality called Mysoma in the middle of Srinagar. Mysoma incidentally is called Gaza Strip because this Gandhian with guns called Yasin Malik lives there. That bridge is called Gaukadal. It has been renamed Madina Chowk. And lo and behold, Srinagar is referred to now as Shehr-e-Khas. In conversations, in writings, in mails. So what are we trying to do? What has come upon us?